hurt me. Yeah, same as the other one. Just don't want to go through here. And once you get the truck past the rock, on the left, then it does alright. Yeah, the other one. See how this one goes. And I have been churning this up. So it used 6 gallons of gas, which is not great. Big boy. With a little bit of assistance. Try to scoot it around a little bit. And I'm going off the road. So let's do it this way. Get out of the road. Oh, that hurt. Wasn't expecting that. Let's see if we can make a U-turn up here. Nope. Here's where the Russian cranes struggle a little bit. Because they're not as powerful when they're stretched out as the American cranes. See, I made 6 and 9 and, or 6 and 10. Did I get, yes I did get consumables. One of those. Activate the anchor. Hitting a trail. There you go. Alright, so that's the two metal pool cargo containers. I forgot about that. I don't know what I was thinking. Should be able to turn around here. I do believe I have the skills. Thought about seeing if I could go through here, but I don't. Don't have cargo containers. Yeah, that sucks. And I read it a little more carefully. I would have just brought a truck down here with a flatbed on it. But I really wanted to try this truck out. But I could have brought this one down with a flatbed on. too late now. I gotta figure out where I can get cargo containers. It might make it easier to get this truck back through. Go closer. Now, don't be shy. Come on, buddy, you can do it. Nope, I think I've churned it up too much. Can't reach. But we've always got this. This might be a good area to bring some of those concrete slabs that we found on Yukon. Bring them down here and drop them in this area. Make it easier to cross. Come down here and pick that rock up and move it. It's part of my problem. Hung up on the big rock, but it'll eventually pull it around. For some reason, I thought the cargo container was something small. Now I have to figure out where I can get cargo containers. think over by the railroad. And I believe I still have the GMC sitting over there. Let me check it out. On the gas. Already through almost half the tank. Halfway. But I have a plan. Yes. No, not that. So I have that big tanker for the generator. So I can keep it full. And that's all. These over till I get to the mud. And I just take the rest of the way individually. That way we can see how this thing's going to do. And we can see how this truck will do through the mud. When it's not pulling something else. Which I know it's going to do. Well. And they still run slow if you have two faster vehicles hook them up, they run half speed. Still hate that. Should run at the speed of the slowest truck. Stop. Parking brake on this thing sucks. All right, we'll take you first. I should have stopped back here and got the new gearbox. Forgot. It does about the same as the other Azov. Just seems to have a little more power. Not in high gear. new gearbox though would help. See if the other Azov went this fast. That would be nice. Delivered. Turned around. Back out on the main road, over to the gas station. Kills this truck is a small gas tank. Other than that, it does very well. All right, twin steer. Load. Looks like I'll be alright. You don't see as much damage from these rocks, which is a good thing. Move pretty quick when it's not pulling out of the truck. Alright, so I need two cargo containers. Find out where they're at. Try not to lock the porch down. Thank you. back of my mind, I knew it was too easy. Having everything over in one player in two places. Alright, so what I'm looking at. GMC. Cargo containers. Alright, where are you at? In relation to me. Oh, that's not far. But you gotta go through here. Which, I was wanting to try the twin steer. So let's just send a twin steer. Pick up both. That one area is where I'm going to bring the collob after it pulls the generator over. If I still need to do that, I'll just leave the collob in that area. Pull trucks through. To my right. I didn't see any signs. So every truck I've brought through here has had trouble. Let's see how you do. Gears a little too much. Yeah, definitely want to bring the collob over here. What if I go push it ashore? Pick up a little extra grip. Try that on the way back. And this isn't too far. I'm not too awful disappointed. Because even if I had cargo containers at the other place, it would still require another trip going back. Slow it down. Flat spot at the tires. Helps. I started putting stickers on the trucks to help me remember which playthrough I'm on. So for this one, I'm using the Tiger. So all the trucks will eventually have that tiger on it for the hardcore mode. Should be about right. No. Loading platform. And anchors. And change the trim. Tight. Right there should do. So actually need to load the back one first. Because if I don't, now for the next one, it's going to hit that one I just loaded. Might even knock truck over. Come on, spin it around. It's a slow spinner. That should be about right. Should be able to get one like that. Yeah, that would have hit that container. Might have either knocked it off or flipped the truck over. Yeah, be careful. Bumping. And put it on. Alright, we're back to ready. So let's go along the shoreline. See if I can get better traction. These are not heavy. But they're heavy enough. I've tried going out a little further where the rocks are. It's still hard for the trucks. I actually think this is a little bit easier. A little bit better grip. Alright, so with these I should have the power plant open. Let's see if we get power to these locations. It says I'll have access. There are three locations that require a generator. So before I drop these off, I'll take a look at the mission again. See if it says I have access to three locations. If it does, that means I don't have to pull that generator around. I just need to take a fuel tank. Or no, I shouldn't have to take a fuel tank. Well, I fill the generator up. Alright, so let's take a look at the mission. There's that one. Access to two locations. Okay. Alright. So the GMC is sitting at one of the locations. The place where I was going to bring the generator, which is around back here. So let's see if I still need a generator for it. Yeah, it looks like I do. No energy. I'll leave you here. Which I have that mission ready to go. Let's try the step. No energy. So what locations did I get access to? I don't know. So I did get access to that. Where else I could get stuff at? I have no idea what areas I have access to now. Unless it's that error. Huh. I have no idea. Alright. So, let's get you moving. This generator over there. And I can make up a bunch of stuff and have it ready. You can pick up if there's no power if you have stuff already made. So I'll make up as much as the fuel tanker will allow me. And you need to wait on the other truck. is 9,000. Whoa, how'd you come unhooked? But with this truck, I'll hook the generator up to it, turn the generator on and off, and it will be sitting next to the tanker. That is my plan. I'm hoping it works. Easy, dude. See if we can get through here by ourselves. I know it's not going to get through that swamp again. Come on, you can do it. I have faith in you. Like I said before, if this thing had all-wheel drive, it would be a beast. We'll slow down for the rocks. And I know better than this, but I'm going to try. It's not gonna make it. Or if it does, it might take 2 hours. I don't know, it's got a little bit of momentum here. I don't know. I think it could make it through here if it didn't have a load on it. It's about halfway. I don't think the trees will help me. Fuel is not a light load. It's still inching. But I think it's had enough now. Yep, it's done. That's pretty good though. Let's go get the co-op. Co-op can pull the rest of the way. Up behind him, my steering. Alright, once I get these over here, the next thing to do will be to head back over there, get some steel, and fix some of these bridges. And then take some steel over to the other map and fix some of those bridges. Now I'm thinking I should have made more steel. I don't know, maybe I can make steel up here. I am very impressed about how far that truck went. Water. Now I have to go around it. I did see a mission that's talking about three sequoia trees delivering them. I'm wondering if the long log trailer can pull them. Are kryptonite. These are small though, so. This truck has very little suspension travel. Oh man, I forgot I've got the active suspension on it. I raised it up. And I'm thinking the days, they have changed something in it. Used to be a full 24-hour period was about an hour of playtime. But it is just now getting dark, and I've been at this almost 2 hours. So I went through one full day, and it's nighttime now. It's starting to get night. I think the game days are longer. Ow. It was turned fast enough. All right, you need to be in the box. Over here. Put it right next to I was going to try to shove it over, but that didn't work. Sorry, as long as it's close. Got my lefts and my rights mixed up. So I can stop you. Turn on the generator. Should be full of gas. And change trucks. And see what I can make here. So I can make fuel. So to make 4 barrels of fuel, it's going to cost me 100 in fuel. Don't know why I would do that. I can make No, I've got cargo containers on the other side. I only had four, though. I know I saw something about large pipes. Three of those. Medium pipes. Got four of those. Small pipes. And refuel. Generator. Generator's still running. Okay. And also, pipes. We have four of those. No cargo to load. All unloading cargo. All right. We got some stuff now. I will have to go in and find out. How much of everything that I actually need. Alright, so we've got a lot of stuff. Oh, I can't make... I may have to pull this generator back here so I can make more steel. I think I still have eight. Yeah, I've still got eight beams. Come on. So I need... Nope, didn't need anything there. I finished that bridge. That one is done. I'm thinking there was another bridge over here. Oh, right there. Leading to railway bridge. What was that? Four metal beams and two concrete slabs. So I've got my four metal beams. Why did it say concrete slabs? Oh, concrete slabs, I'm getting on the other side of it. You go look real quick. Flip over. Parking. Concrete slabs. Yes, unlimited supply. Six fuel left. Two cargo containers left. Unlimited concrete blocks. Four consumables. And unlimited concrete slabs. So that's good. So I will run over and get four metal. Where's it at? I'm still trying to get used to this map. That's GMC, so my garage over here. Okay. Come over here, get four metal. And take it down here. Yeah, just follow that around and that'll lead me to the railway bridge. And then the concrete slabs. Pick up two of those. Probably bring those around here. And then come around here. I still don't know where I can get rolled steel at. Maybe that's something for the other one. The other map. But once I have that finished, then I've got another easy access to the other side of Game Woods River. Ah, so you got to make rolled steel from beams. So it's just the opposite of what we did in Yukon. Rolled steel made beams. Which means I'm going to have to do a lot of traveling from over here, bringing steel to here. Okay. Well, we'll start on that. We'll finish this bridge in the next episode, which will probably be tomorrow night. I want to do one more night on this map before I move into the, or start on the Impasamandra and speed run, because I'm enjoying this and I still got to get my 750 back. But if I fix that bridge, then I can take steel to, let's see, I'll come down through here . What are you? Oh, that's the Western Star. Steel to the North Bridge. And then that'll lead me to the South Bridge. Right over here. I may do the South Bridge first. So I can get the 750 back. It has a broken suspension. So it is stuck there. Yeah, I'll do that one first. There's my garage, and I come around that way. Come across here, over there, fix it, and get the 750 back. And we'll do that in the next episode. So I thank you very much. Appreciate you watching. And I will see you in the next one. So until then, have a good one.